Hi, Olivia Raymond here. If you're looking for a visual task management app, it's probably because you need more clarity. You might be the type of person who is very creative. You always burst with new ideas. You don't know what to do with them. And you need a way to make things actionable. That's where Droptask is very helpful. So here comes Droptask into your riots. First, let's have a quick look at the application and just going to show you how it works very quickly. Let's create a new project. Let's call it TR for tutorials, just as a test. Let's say that I want to organize my holidays. So I'm going to create a group of tasks right now. So I'm going to say, tickets. And packing. I'm going to create two different type of tasks for you to see. So tickets, I'm going to say, I'm going to create my task within the groups. I'm going to say book tickets, renew passport, for example. Call agency. Okay. From here, you go to the task summary and you can set the importance of the task. So let's say call the agency is quite important. It's not very urgent and it doesn't require much effort. So you can see that when you set the effort, the task will change size. So you can see that the more effort it takes to achieve a task, the bigger the bubble will be. So you kind of can't miss it, really. I'm going to assign someone to the task. I'm going to be myself. You can assign other people. You can work. You can assign more than one person to a task. That's what I mean. Let's say that I'm traveling on the 22nd. All right. I'm going to need to make the call, let's say, on the 20th. All right. So that's it. You can see visually immediately the name of the task, who is assigned to the task, how important and how urgent the task really is, when you need to start making the call, and when you need to make sure that the call is made. By 22nd of January, you need to make sure that you made that call. So this is more of a classic task. You can add a note. So let's say call for booking tickets. I don't know. All right, so let's now try another type of task. So I'm gonna write here my name for the packing list, Olivia. And I'm gonna add my partner's name, sorry, Questy. So now I'm gonna create a list of things that I need to pack. So I'm gonna go to my name and I'm gonna go to checklist. You can add subtasks, obviously. So I can write down toiletries, camera, etc., etc. Okay. So in a nutshell, this is how the application works. Obviously, you would need to do a full tutorial to see all the features, but I just want to highlight a few features that I really like. So the first thing that I really, really enjoy about the application is obviously the user interface. I think it is a stunning, stunning application. It bursts with colors. You can add thumbnails to your bubbles so you can recognize them immediately. You can assign dependencies and they are immediately visible. You can see this is a dependency here. Or you can link one task to another. But with dependencies, you can create a workflow. For example, here I have several tasks. If I link them to one another, I can see exactly which task I should start with. All right? There you go. This is, let me just maybe zoom on it. All right, so here I can see exactly which task I should start with. The second feature is the workflow view, which is basically a Kanban view. If you've been using Trello or if you heard about Trello before, then you know what this type of board can really contribute when it comes to your workflow. It's very easy to just move one bubble to another group, and that way you can have your workflow set up and you can go from one group to the other visually. And you can add documents to a task, images, you can have notes, subtasks, tags also. These, what you see on below here, these are tags. So I really like the workflow view. You can also collaborate within a task. So let's say that I want to send a private message to someone. So let me go to a project where I work with other people. And let's say that I want to send a private message to my colleagues. I can just go in comment and add at, and you can see that my colleagues appeared, the name of my colleagues appeared underneath the task. So if I click here and I write a message, my message will go directly to this person. They would then be alerted that they have a message in the desktop notification tab just here. What I really enjoy about the application, and this is important, is that the application is totally scalable. You can start by working on your own and then add as many people as you like, create as many projects as you like, create as many tasks and group of tasks as you like. You can collaborate with people within a task, add as many document pictures as you like. And this is very important as an entrepreneur when you start to grow. If you start on your own and then you start having a team, it's very important that your project management app allow you to really scale. One important thing about Droptask is also the fact that it's available everywhere. You can have it on your Mac, on your phone, on your PC. You can have it online. You can work offline. You know, if I'm on my, I tend to use the Mac Droptask because I prefer the user interface. And I can work offline. If I don't have access to the internet, I can just rearrange my task. And when I go back online, obviously Droptask would catch up with what I've done already. A great integration that is very useful is the Gmail integration. Okay, so for example here, let's say that my dad sent me an email, okay, and that he asked me to do something in that email. I can just click here, create as task in Droptask on the widget added below the email. I can select a project, any project that I would like. So let's say, so I can find it. Let's say that I'm going to put it in, I don't know, gift calendar, I don't know. And add the name of the task, test task. I can set up the importance, the urgency, the effort, start date, and due date. Click create task. Okay, you can view the task now within Droptask. All right, so now you can see that my task appeared inside the project that I selected, okay, with the email message here. So I can get to work immediately and work on this particular task. Another great feature that I think is underrated because people don't realize how powerful this feature is integration with Google Calendar. Because it means that any app that you're using that integrate with Google Calendar would also integrate with Droptask. Okay, so let's say that I'm using Fantastical, which I love. I can just add an event directly from Fantastical. So, call Mary. And then I can add it in one of my Droptask calendar, and the task will appear directly inside a Droptask project. Okay, so that means if I'm working on a note For example, I'm using notebooks as a notebook, all right? And I want to add this task here to Droptask. I can just do that. I can just go to service, add to Fantastic or two, and go to Droptask and add it to Droptask that way. So it's a very handy integration. And every application that you're currently using that integrate with Google Task will integrate with Droptask. If you are an Evernote user, you'll be happy to know that Droptask also integrate with Evernote. You just have to click this button, send task to Evernote, and the task will appear as a note in Evernote. The integration goes both ways. So if you are creating a note into Evernote, you just have to tag it Droptask, and it will appear directly into the Droptask inbox. You can then rearrange the task as it fits you the best. The calendar view is also great in Droptask. Let me show you. The calendar views allow you to see all your tasks within a timeline. So you can actually see visually when your task is due and the upcoming weeks, like how busy your schedule is going to be. And this is the first thing that I open in the morning. You can rearrange the dates just by dragging and dropping a task like this. Here you have listed all your tasks across all your projects. You can just grab a task and choose a due date for the task. I'm going to drop it back here. And you can filter your task also, because sometimes it's just too many of them listed here. So let's say that you can filter them by projects. So I just want to see the project. You can filter them by project. So I just want to see the project in tutorials. There you go. So you can see that all the other tasks disappear and I can focus on tutorials. You can then filter them by importance. I just want to focus on the very important task. And then I want to focus on the most urgent task. All right. So you can see that as I go, the task that I don't need disappear. You can filter them by tags, by attachment, or you can clear all your filters. You can also, if you're working with other people, you can also see their calendar. Right now, I don't really want to look at other people's calendar because I don't think they have any tasks listed. But you can, if you'd like, you can click on your colleagues and see how their timeline look like. If your project manager is quite handy. The last thing I want to say about Droptask very quickly, and that's very important to me, is that the company has probably the best customer support I've ever experienced in my life. And I am not an easy customer. I am not easy at all. I'm a pain. I will go online, put a bad review online because I'm very frustrated when something doesn't work and I'm paying for it. So I will go online and leave a bad review, for example. After let's say I send a ticket and it's taking too long, I will go online and put a review. And I have to say that Droptask has always been very, very nice with me. They always try to engage conversation and say, okay, well, I can see that you're not happy. Let's have a conversation about this. And I've always had to change my reviews because they are so responsive, so polite, courteous with you. They take their time. They make sure that you're happy with what you purchase. And this is, for me, the most important. I will always recommend Droptask. I use them now for more than, I think, 2 years, maybe more. And obviously, I fell in love with Droptask because it's very feature-rich. I think it's a very underrated app because, you know, you can do everything in Droptask. You can set up recurring tasks, dependencies, a group of tasks. You can set up filters too, if needed. Tags, I mean, it's a very feature-rich application that I really recommend you to go and check out. So I hope that this video was somewhat helpful. If you're looking for something different, if you are a visual person, okay, if you need to see the bigger picture, for me, this is very important. I need to have an overview of what I have to do. The list usually don't work for me, but with Droptask, I can see at a glance where I have to focus my effort on. I'm here to serve you. So this was Tutor Riots. I'm Olivia Raymond, and I see you in the next video.